Perfect, we've got three of you online, four of you. Excellent. I think a few people are just joining still. I'm gonna maybe start some light warm-ups. So maybe just open up your arms and just wave them backwards and forwards for me as we start. Hi, welcome. Just wanted to say if you've got a bolster, we're gonna start the Yang and Yin class very soon. Or if you've got a cushion or a block, I would advise you have it by your mat, as we'll probably need that. And if you don't have any of those, then it's fine. We'll improvise, no problem. I don't use them, so it's all good. We're gonna start some warm-ups and get this energy flowing in the body. I'm just gonna wait for a few more people to join. Hope you've all had an amazing day. I can't wait to move. And I hope you guys can see me okay, as this, I'm by the window, but I guess it should be okay. It's just that I can't drop my blinds because they won't go back up otherwise. Bear with me, we'll start in just a few minutes. 1 minute to go. Okay, so maybe if you come onto your mat, we're gonna just start some stretching. So I want you on the inhale to start rising your hands up above your head and bend down and exhale and just do some really subtle movements to really move this energy in our bodies. While everyone starts joining, we're gonna start. I got some dancers joining. We're gonna do a bit of dancing. So just move the elbows and the shoulders round, forwards and backwards. And just continue to do this movement, exhaling as you come down, inhaling as you come up. Just to open out your lungs. Breathing in through the nose, exhaling out through the mouth. And just create some movements. As we warm up the body. Now I want you to place your hands on your shoulder blades and just go round in circular motions, forwards. Inhaling through the nose and exhaling out through the mouth. And anti-clockwise. Really open up those shoulders, especially if we've been sitting all day. We're all very stiff. Now I want you to raise your hands above your head and I want us to go to the right side. Really feel that stretch. Inhaling through the nose and exhaling out through the mouth. Back to center. Now over to the left side. Back to center, one more time to the right. Engage the core muscles as you do this. Breathe in and exhaling out. Perfect. And just shake it all out. Just bounce from left and right. Just waiting for a few more people to join and then we'll go into the stretches. Inhaling and exhaling out through the mouth. Just really open up those shoulders, preparing us for our downward dogs. Perfect. And now I want you to come onto your mat, onto all fours for me, making sure that your shoulders are over wrists, knees in line with the knees. And I want you just to push up to round the spine. So really push up with your arms. Exhale. Now on the inhale, drop the belly. Rise the heart up and forwards. And just do this for a few more times. Exhale, push up. Round the back. And on the inhale, drop the belly. Arch the back. Shine the heart forward and up. Do that for a few more times. I'm just gonna change my playlist. So we start. Okay, perfect. Okay, so pushing up, rounding the back, making sure shoulders are over wrists, knees are under hips. Drop the belly, inhale, arch the back, shine the heart forward and up. One more time, push up, through the arms, through the hands. Inhale, drop the belly, arch the back, shine the heart forward and up. And now I want you just to invite some movement into your body, whether it's a circular movement or whether it's backwards and forwards, going into child's pose. Extend your hands in front of you, making sure that your forearms are on the mat, forehead is on the mat, and you're pushing down and coming back up. So really feel the stretch. So option here to do the circular motions, or you can just push backwards and forwards. Option here, try to get your big toes to touch behind you and just really push down, extend the arms and relax into child's pose. Coming backwards and forwards, just to allow the energy and the fluid in the spine to really flow through, okay? You'll thank me later for this. Okay, and when you've done that, I want you, option here, either continue to do the backwards and forwards positions, otherwise I want you to just hover the knees slightly off the mat. I want you to push back. Push your bum back, push into the heel, push back into your heels. You're on your toes right now. You're coming up into a plank, so you're coming up onto your toes. Drop the knees down, so you're basically doing a box, and you're coming around. So this is a spinal wave you're doing, and this is very good for your spine. Try to do that if you can. Hover the knees off the mat, push back through the heels, up, round in a plank, hold up. Your plank with your hands, you're on your toes, drop the knees slightly and push back and come round. So you're doing a wave motion with your body. Okay? Otherwise, just continue to push back into child's pose. If you want an extended child's pose, create a shark fin behind your back, behind your head, making sure that your elbows are on the mat. And just hold here for a few breaths. Breathing in through your nose and exhaling out through the mouth. And while you're in this position, I want you just to think, set an intention for your practice that you want to work on today. And just really resonate with your body, connect with it. And really just resonate with what you want to work on today. If you're feeling low on energy or if you want to push yourself, don't have any expectation. Just really connect with your breath and try to synchronize it with the movements that you're doing today. That's what I want you to do. And just enjoy it. So now I want you to come up when you're ready onto all fours again. And I want you to extend your right hand out and your left leg out. Your toes are pointing downwards, so your pinky toe is pointing down onto the mat and your leg is flexed and your core muscle is engaged, okay? And now I want you to bring your right elbow to your left knee. One. We're gonna do three of these. Really engage your glutes and your core. bringing your right elbow to your left knee. Two, three, and come back onto all fours. And I want you to do it on the other side. Extend your left hand, your left arm with your right leg out. Pinky toe is pointing downwards. So you're flexing your foot. Inhale, elbow to knee. Exhale, extend. Bring your elbow to knee, elbow extends. One more, left elbow to right knee. Hold, and then extend. Perfect, and now, bring your left hand up to the ceiling. Really stretch up, and now we're gonna thread the left hand under the right arm, and you're gonna place your left shoulder blade onto your mat. Thread it through, making sure the shoulder blade is on the mat. Now thread that up, inhale. Exhale, thread the hand forward and through. One more, inhale, rise the left hand up to the ceiling. Exhale, fold that through, make sure the shoulder blade is touching the mat. And rise that hand back up, and then come back to a neutral spine onto all fours, and we're gonna do that on the other side. So rise your right hand, your right arm up into the ceiling. Look towards your middle finger, and on the exhale, thread that through and under, making sure your right shoulder blade is touching the mat. Inhale, rise the hand up, look towards your middle finger, thread that arm through, placing the shoulder blade onto the mat. One more, inhale, rise the right hand up. Exhale, fold that through. Perfect. And now I want you to bring your hands into a cactus position, and we're gonna flicker the hands for 10. Really fast. This will help as well when we're on our mats. So we're clawing our mat strongly so we have a firm grip once we're in downward dog and doing all the other poses. Perfect. And now I want you to come back onto all fours, and we're gonna hit the tops of our feet onto the mat again for 10 seconds. And this will help to remove any stagnant energy out of the feet. So let's go. Faster, harder. Perfect. Lovely. So now I hope you're ready to flow. So what I want you to do is to come onto the front of your mat. I want you to pigeon toe your feet slightly inwards, externally rotate the shoulder blades backwards. I want you to tuck your tailbone in, so you're pushing the glutes in, bum is not sticking out, always in mountain pose. Okay, you're micro-bending the knees slightly to dust in a mountain pose. And we're standing strong here, clawing the air with our hands by our sides. And just close your eyes here for a few breaths, just to ground yourself. Inhaling through the nose and exhaling out through the mouth. And now on the inhale, I want you to rise the hands up above your head, Arva Hastasana. Claw the air with your hands. Imagine there's a beach ball in between them. And now on the exhale, I want you to fold forwards, plant the hands down on the mat, look towards your navel or to the back of the room. Really fold forwards. Now on the inhale, halfway lift, squeeze the shoulder blades and flat back, lengthen. Exhale, plant the hands down on the mat. And I want you to step or jump back into Palakasana plank position. Now inhale, lengthen, push up onto the toes. Option here to drop the knees down onto the mat, modify Palakasana, untuck the toes, shift the weight forwards, making sure that you externally rotate the elbows in so they glide by your ribs. Recline down slowly, Chaturanga. Bhujangasana, so now on the inhale, rise the hands up by your sides, chin is tucked in. Exhale, plant the hands down on the mat, push up into cobra. And now on the exhale, push back up into downward facing dog. And now this is your first dog. I want you to walk your dog, shifting the weight from left to right. Really feel the stretch in your hamstrings. Really feel the stretch. And just take your time here. Inhaling through the nose and exhaling out through the mouth as you walk your dog. And now I want you to look to the front of the mat, step or jump to the front, and on the inhale, halfway lift, squeeze the shoulder blades, flat back lengthen, and exhale, come up to Dasana Mountain Pose. Now making sure that you're tucking your tailbone inwards, you're hugging your ribs in, externally rotate the shoulder blades, and on the inhale, rise the hands up, Arva Hastasana. Claw the air with your hands. Imagine that beach ball, really active. Exhale, fold forward. Uttanasana, look towards your navel, hug the ribs in. Inhale, halfway lift. Flat back, lengthen, squeeze the shoulder blades. Exhale, plant the hands back down. Step back into Palakasana, plank pose. Now on the inhale, I want you to push up onto your toes. High plank. Now option to drop the knees down onto the mat. Otherwise, prepare yourself for a Chaturanga. Externally rotate the shoulders and the elbows in. Come down into Chaturanga. Untuck the toes, push up into upward cobra. And then exhale, push back up into downward facing dog. Now stay here for 3 breaths. Shift the weight if you want from left to right. Otherwise, stay in your downward dog. And now on the inhale, I want you to look towards the front of the mat, step or jump to the front. Now on the inhale, halfway lift, flat back, lengthen, exhale, Tadasana Mountain Pose. Now on the inhale, I want you to rise the hands up, sit low, reach high. Imagine there is a comfy chair underneath you, Utkatasana. Really engage your core here, look up to the ceiling. Now exhale, fold forwards, plant the hands on the mat. Look towards your navel or to the back of the room. Really fold forwards. Now on the inhale, halfway lift, squeeze the shoulder blades. Flat back, lengthen. Exhale, plant the hands down and step back into Palakasana, plank position. Inhale, lengthen, push up onto the toes. Now option again, do the modified Palakasana, drop the knees, untuck the toes, shift the weight forwards, squeeze the elbows in so they're by your ribs, tuck the chin in as you come down onto the mat. Now bring your hands up by your sides, Bhujangasana, making sure that your elbows are touching your ribs. Now drop the hands back down, exhale. Push up, inhale, upward facing dog, cobra. Exhale, push up into downward facing dog. Now I want you to shift the weight left and right, and I want you to unite the feet together. And I want you to shift the weight into the left foot as we rise the right leg up to the ceiling. I want you to open up that hip, and I want you to rotate your ankle clockwise and anti-clockwise. Really feel that. And now I want you to try and bring your heel as close as possible to your bum. Now bring that foot forwards to your nose. So bring your knee to your nose and then bring that foot forwards to the front of the mat. Try and square your hips. Option to drop the left knee onto the mat to untuck the toes. Option 2, to come into crescent lunge. Rise the hands up on the inhale. Option 2, raise your knee off the mat and come into a high lunge, Alanasana. Now, bring your hands to heart center. Really find your focus point. And now I want you to bring your left elbow over to your right and place that onto your right knee and twist, making sure your right elbow is pointing up to the ceiling. Option here is to open up your triangle, otherwise stay where you are. Now bring your hands back to heart center. Rise the hands up. Really engage your core here. Bring the hands under the legs. Rise up. One. Exhale. Inhale, rise the hands up. Exhale, bring them under the knee. Under your knee. And rise the hands back up. And now I want you to plant the hands back down on the mat. And I want you to step back into plank position. Come up onto your toes. And now push back into downward facing dog. Shift the weight from left to right. Unite the feet. And I want you to shift the weight into your right foot. Slightly microbend the right foot. And raise the left leg up into the sky, to the ceiling. Open up the hip. And I want you to rotate the ankle round to the right. Round clockwise and then anti-clockwise. Now try and bring that heel as close as possible to your bum. And then bring that forward to your knees, touching your nose. And then one more time, raise the leg up to the ceiling. Bring that heel to bum, knee to nose, and then bring that foot forwards, framing your hands to the front of the mat. Option, drop the right knee, untuck the toes. Inhale, rise the hands up. Option two, raise the knee off the mat. Bring your hands to heart center, and I want you to twist over to your left side. So bringing your right elbow over to your left knee, making sure that your left elbow is pointing up to the ceiling. Inhale here, hold for two breaths. Option here to open your triangle, otherwise just stay where you are. Now bring your hands back to heart center. And again, I want you to raise your hands up to the ceiling. Exhale, bring them under your knee, under your leg. Inhale, rise up. Exhale, fold under. Inhale, rise up. So we're basically doing lunge pulses. Inhale, rise the hands up. Exhale, fold them under the knee. One more. Inhale, rise the hands up. Exhale, fold the hands under. Now plant the hands back onto the mat. Step back into plank position. Hold your plank strong. Inhale, push up onto your toes. And then push back into downward facing dog. Walk your dog for three breaths. And now I want you to shift the weight into your left foot again. Rise the right leg up. And now I want you to bring that right knee to your right elbow. And then rise that right leg up again. Bring that right knee over to your left elbow. This is a lot of core work we're doing. Rise the leg up. And now I want you to bring that foot through to your nose and then through to the front of the mat. And then with your back foot, I want you, before you rise up, I want you to drop the back foot so it's 90 degree angle. And now I want you to open up into warrior two. Making sure you're shifting the weight into your right knee. You're opening up warrior two. Virabhadrasana two, look towards your middle finger. Really tuck your tailbone in so the bum is not sticking out. And now I want you on the exhale to reverse your warrior, Viparita Virabhadrasana. Exhale, open. One more time, Viparita, reverse your warrior. Exhale, open. Now I want you to bring that right forearm onto the right knee. Bring your back arm, scoop it down and under and over the head. Look towards your middle finger. Uttita Parsvottanasana. One more time, exhale, open your warrior. Shift that weight into your right knee. Gaze is over the middle finger. Make sure that your stance is strong, tailbone is tucked. Now bring that right forearm back onto the right knee. Bring the back hand down and round and over the head. Uttita Parsvottanasana. Again, exhale, open your warrior. Strong. Now extend that front knee So it's straight, back leg is straight. And I want you to try and grab onto your ankle if you can. Otherwise, if your hand won't touch your ankle, try to get as low as possible. Raise the left hand, the left arm up, up to the ceiling. Look towards your middle finger here. This is Trikonasana, triangle. Now exhale, open your warrior. And now make sure you shift the weight into that right knee. And now I want you to bring your right palm and place it on the inner side of your right foot. So plant your palm, your right hand onto the mat, and then again, raise your left hand up, pointing to the ceiling, and your gaze is up towards your middle finger or your thumb. Option one. Option two, bring that left hand behind your back and do a bind. Option three, you can bring your right hand and bring it under the leg to clasp onto your left hand. So you're clasping your hands behind your back. Your right knee is bent and your left leg is straight. Inhale for two breaths here, hold. Now to unravel, place the palm, your right palm back on your inner thigh. Raise the left hand up and then open up, exhale into warrior two. Now I want you to pivot that right leg inwards. We're gonna come into a wide-legged dog. I want you to just have buoyancy in the knees, making sure there's a slight micro bend. Bring your hands on your hips, and I want you to fold forward slowly, vertebrae by vertebrae, making sure that your knees are still slightly bent, and you're folding forwards. Option here to grab onto the ankles. Option two to place the palms of the hands in the middle of the mat, and just fold. Inhale here, through the nose, exhale out through the mouth. Now, I want you to bring your hands back on your hips and raise up vertebrae by vertebrae, slowly rising. Now, I want you to pivot the left foot out, shift the weight into the left knee, and we're gonna open up Virabhadrasana 2 on the other side. Okay, making sure you're tucking your tailbone, your bum's not sticking out. Look towards your middle finger. Now on the exhale, reverse your warrior, Viparita. Exhale, open. One more time. Exhale, reverse your warrior. Open up your warrior, making sure you're shifting the weight into that left knee. Now bring your left forearm onto your left knee. Scoop the back hand down and round and over the head. Uttita Parsvottanasana, look towards your middle finger. Exhale, open your warrior, making sure that your stance is really strong. Your neck and your shoulders are relaxed. Again, bring that forearm back onto the knee. Bring the back hand down and round and over the head. Exhale, open up your warrior. Now extend that left foot. Reach for your ankle, inhale, rise the right hand up. Look towards your middle finger. Now I want you to shift the weight into that left knee. Bring your left palm onto the mat. Raise your right hand up. Option, bring the right hand behind your back. Left hand comes under to do a bind. That's an option here. Otherwise, just stay in Trikonasana. No problem. Otherwise, if you want to do the bind and it's in your practice, then do that. But there's no expectation here. It's not about flexibility. It's about your breath. It's about synchronizing movement. Now exhale, open up into warrior two. Pivot that left foot inwards, making sure that there's buoyancy in the knees. I want you to bring your hands to heart center. And we're gonna go into a goddess pose. So I want you to raise the right heel off the mat. I want you to drop the right heel down, and we're going to alternate. Rise the left heel off the mat, and we're just going to do that for a few breaths, making sure that your spine, you're lengthening. Inhale, rise the right heel. Then we go to the left. Keep pulsing here. Strong glutes, strong abs, strong core. Lengthen the spine. Lovely. Now I want you to come down, if you can, making sure the soles of your feet are on the mat. And we're going into a yogi squat. So bring your hands back to heart center. Tops of your arms are pushing into the knees and you're pushing outwards. Sit up tall, lengthen the spine. Open up, Malasana. Inhale through the nose and exhale out through the mouth. Continue to breathe. Really feel the stretch in your hamstrings, in your groin area. Perfect. And now we need to rise up slowly. And now we're gonna come down again into downward facing dog for me. Shift the weight left and right. You should be feeling really stretched out now. Okay, now I want you to shift the weight into that left foot, rise the right leg up. And now I want you to bring that right leg back to the front of the mat, pivot that foot outwards, your back leg, and I want you again to open up into warrior two. And now we're gonna do a mandala, okay? So what I want you to do, pivot that foot in, we're gonna regulate the chi. Bring your hands to the middle into a ball, generate some energy here. And now I want you to pivot the left foot out and open up your warrior. But diagonally, open up the arms strong. Hold for two breaths, now pivot that left foot in. Come to the middle, create this ball of energy. Circulate, connect with your breath. Close your eyes, pivot the right foot out and open up your warrior, strong. Shifting the weight into that right knee, opening up, imagining there's a sword in your hand. Inhale, exhale, come back to the middle. Regulate your chi. Again, inhale, open. Shift that weight into that left knee. Pivot that foot in, come back to the middle, one more. Pivot that right foot out and open up your warrior, strong, diagonal arms. Core is tucked, everything is strong and active. Now what I want you to do now, bring your feet 2 feet distance apart, making sure that you have 2 feet distance in between the legs. And what I want you to do, we're gonna shift forwards into a pyramid pose. So what I want you to do is to fold forwards to grab onto the ankle, making sure the back leg is straight, right leg is slightly bent. And we're going over to bend forwards, option to plant the hands onto the mat, fingertips are on the mat. Otherwise, grab onto the ankle and fold. Inhale here for 2 breaths and exhale. And now I want you to raise, as you rise up, I want you to lift your back leg up behind you, making sure the foot is flexed and the toes are pointing down. Your hands come behind you. Your front leg is slightly bent, warrior three. Now on the inhale, bring that leg up. I'm gonna turn around to face you, making sure that the left knee is up. We're gonna go into Vrikkonasana, bring your right hand onto your hip, your left hand is on your knee, and on the exhale, I want you to open. Inhale to close, exhale to open, inhale to close, making sure that you find your focus and your drishti in the middle of the room somewhere to focus, making sure that your right foot is grounded onto your mat. Exhale, open and bring the sole of your foot to the bottom calf, option one, avoiding the knee, option two, to bring the sole up to your upper calf. Push the sole into your upper calf, bring your hands to heart center, focus, breathe, option two, open up your tree. Bring your hands into mudra, or prayer above your head. Focus here, inhaling and exhaling, strong focus. Bring your hands back to heart center. And then bring that foot up, touch the ground and shake it all out. And now we're gonna do eagle. I don't know if that's in your practice, but if it is, you're welcome to try. So again, I want you to start same leg, so your left leg up, and I want you to wrap that round the right. So your foot is going all the way round and trying to get round to the back of your leg, to the back of your calf. Option two is to point your big toe onto the mat. So you're just wrapping it round and you're touching it if it doesn't wrap around your calf. And now bring your right hand over your left. Wrap it round. Palms are touching each other, so the fronts of your hands are clasped together. And we're gonna fold forwards. Oops, my balance isn't that great. Let's try again. And fold forwards for a few breaths. Hold your focus. And then rise up, unravel, shake it all out. And we're gonna repeat that on the other side. So what I want you to do, making sure that you ground your left leg, your left foot into the mat strong, the toes are opened and spaced out. Raise your right leg up, your left hand is on your hip, right hand is on your knee, and then on the exhale, open, making sure the foot is flexed. Inhale, close. Exhale to open. Inhale to close. One more, exhale, open, and place the sole of your foot on the lower calf. Again, make sure you avoid the knee as you can injure yourself. Option two, bring the sole of the foot on the upper calf, pushing the sole into the upper calf. Bring your hands, making sure your hips are square, pointing forwards. Bring your hands to heart center, lengthen, find your focal point in the room. Option two, open your tree. Bring your hands above your head into prayer option. Otherwise, hands in mudra for concentration. Inhaling through the nose, exhaling out through the mouth. Bring your hands back to heart center. Raise that right leg up and wrap it round the left. Otherwise, bring the big toe onto the mat. And I want you to bring the left hand over the right, wrapping it round, and then we're shifting forwards, Garudasana, eagle pose. Find your focus, your balance. Concentration is everything. And then raise up, unravel, and shake it all out. Shift the weight from left and right. And now I want you to come down onto your mats for me. We're gonna go into downward facing dog. I want you to really shift the weight left and right just to stretch out the hamstrings. If you're feeling any pain, that's normal if you don't practice those poses. Really stretch out the spine. And I want you to shift the weight into the left foot, raise the right leg up. And I want you to bring that leg through to the front, but placing your leg on the outer edge of your mat. So we're coming and we're dropping the left knee down, untucking the toes, and we're going into a lizard. So make sure your foot is on the outer edge of the mat. Bring your forearms down onto the mat, making sure you really open up your hip here as we're coming down. Place the forearms onto the mat, and you should really feel this in your groin, in your hip area. If you're tight, that's normal. And now come down onto the mat. Option, place your forehead, create a pillow with your hands. Otherwise, get a bolster or a cushion and just place it
onto your mat just to rest your head if you can't get low enough, okay? And we're gonna hold this pose for 2 minutes. Really feel this. This is amazing if you've got tight hamstrings, if you do a lot of running. This is amazing. You're gonna thank me after. Really open up the hips, really push into this pose. And I want you to come up, placing the palms onto the mat. Push that right leg back into a plank position. Shift the weight forwards. Shift the weight forwards. Make sure the elbows are tucked in. Rise down slowly, chaturanga. Untuck the toes. Come into upward cobra. And then push back into downward facing dog on the exhale. Walk your dog for 3 breaths. Shift that weight into the right foot, into the right knee, micro-bend the right knee. Raise the left leg up. And I want you to bring that left leg forwards and through to the edge of the mat on the other side. Drop the right knee down. And again, open up the hip, untuck the toes. Really push, open up. And now again, bringing the forearms down and resting your forehead on the mat or on a cushion. Really engage, really feel the stretch. We tend not to open up our muscles here, and we should be using a foam roller as our fascia and connective tissues are very stiff. And yin yoga is what helps when you hold these positions for much longer periods. It opens up the hip joints and the connective tissues so they're more flexible and lighter. Now come up onto the palms of your hands, and I want you to push back again into Palakasana plank position. Hold strong. Externally rotate the elbows in. Come up onto your toes. Shift the weight forwards. Come down slowly. Untuck the toes. Push up into upward cobra. Inhale. Exhale, push back into Atta Mukha Svanasana, downward facing dog. Shift the weight from left to right. And now I want you to come back onto plank. Push back into downward facing dog. Shift the weight into the left foot. Raise the right leg up. And now I want you to bring that foot forwards and through, but in a 45 degree angle. So we're going into a pigeon pose. So what your leg is, it's basically diagonal, okay? And you're trying to get your hip down as much as you can. So if your right leg is diagonal, the right bum cheek doesn't have to touch the mat. If you've got a bolster or a block, you can put it underneath, as it's not meant to touch the mat. You just have to try and get your hips as square as you can. And now again, rise the hands up, and I want you to fold forwards and place the forearms down on the mat, and placing your forehead again on the mat or on a cushion or a bolster. And I really want you to really breathe into this pose. As women, we hold a lot of tension in our solar plexus, in the stomach area, and this pose is really beneficial for us to really open up. And even for men as well, for the hips, they're really tight, from other exercises, so it's really good to open up this in any sort of exercise. We should be doing this before and after and holding it for a minimum of 2 minutes. Placing your forehead on the cushion or on the mat, or you can create a pillow, and just breathe here deeply. The more you breathe, the better it is, like it will be less painful because you're breathing into that space where it needs to be, that where it needs breath. That's why it's so stiff. Inhaling through the nose and exhaling out through the mouth. And now I want you to come up, place the palms on the mat, rise up, rise the hands up, inhale. Now bring the hands back onto the mat, and I want you to push back into downward facing dog. Might feel a bit like jelly, may feel very stiff, that's fine. It will feel better when you stand up, shifting the weight left and right. Now shift the weight into the right foot, right leg, micro bend, raise the left leg up. And again, bring that left foot forwards, dropping that left knee down on the mat. The leg is diagonal. The right leg, you're releasing down and you're untucking your toes. And you're really trying to get as low as possible. If there's a small gap, again, under your butt, your left bum cheek, that's normal, that's fine. It doesn't have to be touching. More support, again, bring the bolster underneath or the block. And again, inhale, rise the hands up and fold forwards. Placing your head on your hands or on a cushion. And really breathe into this stretch. Inhaling through the nose and exhaling out through the mouth. I know it's painful for me, but it's so good. Afterwards, you're gonna love it. Really breathe into this. It's not fun, but it's very beneficial for your health and for your hips and for your joints. But one more minute. Breathe, continue to keep breathing. And I want you to again place the palms on the mat, rise the hands up. Exhale, place the palms back onto the mat, and I want you to come back into downward facing dog. So lifting that left leg back and then pushing down into downward facing dog. Really feel the stretch, shifting the weight left and right again. And now I want you to come down, drop the knees down. Shift the weight onto the right side. Bring your feet round to the front. On the inhale, rise the hands up above your head, making sure that the feet are flexed, toes are pointing upwards. We're going into a forward fold, Paschimottanasana. Make sure your knees are slightly bent so you're not extending them out, over flexing them. And now I want you on the inhale, rise the hands up and fold forwards, come down. Option to touch your toes or behind your feet or grab onto your ankles. And if you can't, just try to just fold forwards, as the aim is not about touching your heels or your toes, it's about folding forwards. That's the aim of this pose. Continue to breathe in through your nose and exhale out through the mouth. the exhale, rise up. And now I want you to bring your legs together. So we're coming in. So bring the soles of your feet together. We're going to go into a bound butterfly. Open up the legs. Try and lengthen your spine. Sit up tall. Inhale. And just bounce the legs for a few times here. Just to really loosen up any stiffness again in the hips. Option here, if you do have a bolster and you can't hold onto your feet and bounce the legs, you can bring the bolster and place your head on it and just sit here for a few breaths. That's an option. Otherwise, just keep opening up the hips. And now I want you to just swing around. Sorry, I was facing you so you can see me. Now I want you to recline down onto your mat. And we're gonna go and do a supported bridge. So come down. And I want you to bring your heels as close as possible to your glutes, to your butt cheeks. And I want you just to get comfortable, making sure that your spine and your lower back is glued onto the mat. Place your hands by your sides, palms facing down. Now on the inhale, I want you to rise your glutes up. So you're shifting the weight upwards, rising up. Bring your hands underneath you. Feet are straight, feet are pointing outwards. You're squeezing your glutes as you rise up. Hands are clasped underneath you. So interlace the fingers, if you can. Squeeze in the glutes and hold. Hold for three breaths. Inhale through the nose. Exhale out through the mouth. Now I want you to remove the hands from underneath you. And all I want you to do is to release down. And we're going to do some pulses. Inhale, rise. Exhale, release. Inhale, rise. Squeeze the glutes at the top. Exhale, release. Inhale, rise. Squeeze the glutes. Exhale, release. Inhale, rise. Exhale, release. Inhale, rise. Squeeze at the top. Exhale, release. Inhale, rise. Squeeze again. Hold. Exhale, release. One more. Inhale, rise. Really squeeze those glutes at the top and then exhale, release. Now, as we inhale and rise, I want you to raise your right leg up. So we're gonna rise up, squeeze the glutes at the top, and then raise the right leg up, straighten, lengthen. And now bring that leg down, release, come down, and we're gonna do the other side. So, on the inhale, rise the glutes up to the top, and I want you to get the left leg and rise that up at the top. Active foot and active leg, and you're squeezing the glutes. And now, release, come down. Now I want you to lengthen both legs out onto the mat. And now we're gonna go into a fish pose. So if this isn't in your practice, I'm gonna guide you through it. So if you do have a block and you wanted to do an extended fish pose, or if you've got a towel or something, you can put it under your back, but I'm not gonna use any props. So I want you to just have a look at what I'm doing first, if you haven't done this before. This is a really nice heart opener. So what you're gonna do is we're gonna bring the back onto the mat, and I have the option here to have your legs straight out, otherwise bend them inwards slightly. And I want you just to lift your head up. So you're basically touching your mat with the middle of your head, and you're rising the shoulders up and your chest is up. And this is the fish pose. So you're really engaging
your shoulders away from your ears, and you're just pushing up to open up the chest. So try to do that if you can, if you feel comfortable. If you haven't got a bad neck, or you're not, if you haven't got any injuries, I hope no one has any injuries, but please let me know if you do. Otherwise, don't practice it. All good? Okay, try to do that, as it's a really amazing pose to just open up the heart, if you can. And just inhale through the nose and exhale out through the mouth. And what's a really good exercise, if you want to buy a yoga wheel, this is the most amazing thing. If you want to practice the wheel, the full wheel, I won't do the wheel today, but I will do that in the next class, as I'm not sure what everyone's level is, but this is an amazing wheel to open up the back if you haven't done it. So basically you place it in the middle of your back and you just literally lay back on it, and this opens up your chest and your heart and really allows you to stretch open. So that's a good practice before doing the full wheel. Okay, and now what I want us to do, we're gonna just open up, so lengthen the spine, and I want you to raise back up. Inhale, raise the hands up. And we're gonna fold forwards again to counteract that, making sure you microbend the knees and you're folding forwards to touch your ankles or to touch the back of your foot or your toes.